delighted that all of you are here. Thank you very much for taking the time out of your day to participate in this program. The topic for today's recital is organ improvisation. We've heard, of course, from a number of composers in the last few weeks. We've heard from, Couperin and Frescobaldi and Papabel and others. And today we're taking a bit of a departure from the standard repertoire to listen to organ improvisation. Improvisation is, simply put, a musical composition that is composed at precisely the same time it is performed. We generally associate improvisation not with classical music, but with jazz. Jazz players do this all the time. And you probably know how that works, right? There's usually a tune, what jazz players like to call the head, and they'll take that tune and begin to elaborate on it. And of course, if it's an ensemble, even if it's a solo piece, they'll keep elaborating usually in ever more complex ways. At one point, improvisation was in fact the province of classical musicians. And even among classical musicians, there are not that many who even believe that at first when I tell them. I tell them, violinists used to improvise, and clarinet players used to improvise, and keyboard players used to improvise. And they say, oh no, we could never do that. We have to play the notes that are on the page, and only those notes, and no other notes. When in fact, if we go back to, say, the 17th century, 18th century, right up on through to the 19th century, and certainly well before that time, in fact, it was improvisation that was considered the height of the art form. You can go so far as to say that many of the works of Bach were written not so much as performance pieces, but rather as pedantic pieces, pieces that were written so that students might learn good form for when they created improvisations. Now, what I'm going to do today is take five hymns that at least I associate with the season of Lent, the season that we're in right now, and create improvisations based on those tunes as unique and separate works. So five different works will fill up our time this morning. To be fair, I will play the tune in a very simple form, just so you can hear it once, shall we say, unadulterated. I suspect you'll know most of the tunes, if not all of them. They're very familiar. Again, typically associated with Lent. Just a couple of disclaimers, if you will. These are not improvisations that you could sing to. These are not free accompaniments for hymns, as you might sometimes hear. You will not be able to sing to these if you were to try. You could try, but I wouldn't advise it. Second disclaimer, I'm playing the tunes at the beginning because in some cases the improvisation will be largely inspired by the tune, but you may not actually hear the tune in any contiguous form within it. You probably will hear some snips of it, but it may be difficult to pull out, just as in some Bach choral preludes. It's ostensibly based on a tune, but the tune is never presented in its entirety the way that it's sung. The final disclaimer is, these are probably not church pieces. These are probably not pieces we play on a Sunday morning, unless you were in a church that was really, really heavily into organ music. These are probably the kind of pieces that could get organists pink slip on the key desk the following day, or at least so I've been told. Not here, but in other places. These are probably very much within the style and genre of the late 20th and 21st centuries, so be forewarned. Hopefully it will not be too offensive to you. I'll be happy to take questions afterwards. Okay? And again, thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.